Welcome to today's video on vitamin D and blood sugar control. Vitamin D is a unique vitamin believed to influence over 2,000 different genes in the body, but it can be tricky to navigate. Now, vitamin D impacts bone health, immunity, heart health, brain health, lung function, and indirectly, it can impact blood sugar control by influencing insulin production and sensitivity, potentially allowing better glucose uptake by cells. Vitamin D comes from sunshine, foods, and supplements, but they aren't all equal in terms of benefits and functions, and furthermore, vitamin D efficacy can depend on other factors. So today, we'll dive into this complex topic and attempt to present it in practical and useful terms, exploring how vitamin D may help to manage blood sugar, looking at the science and latest research, and laying out a few important tips, actionable steps to help you stay on track, including foods that work synergistically with vitamin D to increase benefits. But before we get into it, can you do us a favor and like this video, ring the bell for future notifications, and make sure you subscribe to Diabetics Talk for more practical diabetes information. Plus, stick around to find out how you can get not one, not two, but three free gifts. Also, don't forget to check out exclusive Diabetics Talk merchandise from our store and sign up as a member to get full access to the Food Health and You Complete Implementation System documentary, and more. A 2023 study published in the journal Nutritional Epidemiology found that an estimated 15% of the global population is deficient in vitamin D, or one in every seven people on Earth, with that figure skyrocketing in higher latitude countries. This is important because vitamin D plays a crucial role. It's particularly important for bone and heart health, for directing calcium into bones and keeping it out of arteries, where it can cause heart disease, a common progression of type 2 diabetes. But the thing is, this can rely on other vitamins, which we'll get into. Moreover, vitamin D deficiency has been linked to an increased risk of certain types of cancer, autoimmune disorders, infectious diseases, mental health disorders, and impaired immune function. And what about blood sugar control? Well, that ties in with everything we've discussed, because all of these factors are interconnected. Now, the thing with vitamin D is that being deficient is the problem. It's not like omega-3, where the more you get, the better. But major problems show up with a deficiency or poor vitamin D function. For example, the famous D2D study found that for people who were deficient in vitamin D, supplementation led to a 62% reduction in type 2 diabetes risk. However, when it comes to supplementation, it's a real balancing act. Deficiency may occur due to insufficient exposure, poor absorption, or unique metabolic needs that mean you require more. A number of studies have looked at vitamin D deficiency and high blood sugar, as well as complications that lead from type 2 diabetes. The groundbreaking 2017 study titled Vitamin D Deficiency in Diabetes investigated exactly how cell processes are impacted by vitamin D and how this can influence blood sugar control. Diabetes typically starts with insulin resistance, where the body's cells become less responsive to the hormone insulin. Insulin is produced by specialized cells in the pancreas called beta cells, and it helps regulate our blood sugar levels by allowing glucose or blood sugar to enter our cells for energy. For example, when you walk, lift groceries, or work out at the gym, your body uses glucose, which needs to get from the bloodstream into your muscles in order to function. Insulin is like a key that unlocks a door in cells so they can take in glucose from the blood. Just like a key opens a locked door, insulin binds to receptors on the cell's surface, triggering a chain of events that allows glucose to enter from the bloodstream. When high blood sugar becomes type 2 diabetes, insulin resistance develops. It's as if the lock or the insulin receptor becomes rusty, and the key or insulin can no longer open the door as efficiently, leaving glucose stranded in the bloodstream. What's more, beta cells in the pancreas compensate by producing more insulin so that your body can continue to function. This initially helps. However, this increased activity puts a strain on the pancreas, leading to the death of beta cells. Here's where vitamin D comes into play. Firstly, vitamin D helps reduce inflammation, which is a significant factor in insulin resistance. By reducing inflammation, it can help improve the sensitivity of cells to insulin, thereby combating the initial stage of pre-diabetes. Secondly, vitamin D helps regulate the levels of calcium ions in the beta cells. During diabetes, these levels become elevated and contribute to cell damage. Vitamin D helps keep these levels in check, preventing stress on the beta cells and preserving their function. So vitamin D is essential. It protects the pancreas and it may help to get glucose into the cells in your muscles. That's how vitamin D supplements led to that 62% decreased risk for type 2 diabetes. But the important point to note is that the benefit was only for people who were vitamin D deficient, which brings us to the next point. How you get your vitamin D can make a difference. According to Johns Hopkins research, for people who are deficient in vitamin D, supplementation can make a positive difference. However, beyond a certain level, artificial vitamin D supplementation can cause harm. The Johns Hopkins study looked at 15,000 participants and found that vitamin D supplementation beyond 21 nanograms per milliliter increased C-reactive protein levels, indicating inflammation, which is associated with stiffening of blood vessels and an increased risk of heart disease. Thus, vitamin D supplementation may be useful in some cases, but should only ever be taken under expert medical guidance. It's important to make informed decisions. On the other hand, we have natural vitamin D exposure through the big ball in the sky, the sun. Vitamin D can be found in two forms, vitamin D2 and vitamin D3. The sun gives us D3. A 2012 study published in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition showed that vitamin D3 is more effective in raising blood sugar concentrations. Essentially, it's absorbed more easily by the body. The researchers also found that D3 had a more sustained impact, maintaining vitamin D levels in the body for longer, while D2 quickly becomes deactivated. And to take this a step further, research by MIT senior researcher Dr. Stephanie Seneff found that even if you do get vitamin D3 from a supplement, it's not the same as the real deal from the sun exposure. According to her research, our skin produces a special type of vitamin D3 when exposed to sunlight, called vitamin D3 sulfate. Unlike the vitamin D3 found in supplements, which is fat soluble, vitamin D from the sun is water soluble, meaning it can move freely in our bloodstream and doesn't require cholesterol to transport it around the body. So through sun exposure, we also get this extra compound called sulfate. Now, sulfate is interesting on its own. Our blood vessels are lined with a special layer called glycocalyx. It's like wallpaper inside the tubes that our blood flows through. Sulfate, which is produced in our bodies when we're exposed to sunlight, helps strengthen this layer. This delivery is extremely important for keeping the cells that line our blood vessels strong and resilient. This whole process helps create something called an exclusion zone. a layer of gel that coats the surface of blood vessels, a protective gel layer like bubble wrap or styrofoam that protects electronics when they're being delivered. The exclusion zone gel is vitally important for protecting blood vessels and artery walls from damage associated with high blood sugar. And the exciting thing is, researchers believe that vitamin D sulfate, the one you get from sun exposure, may cause this exclusion zone to expand dramatically, expanding up to 4 times in width, ramping up your body's defense against high blood sugar damage, like atherosclerosis and cardiovascular disease. Now, before we continue, how about those free gifts? Discover an entire world of diabetes-fighting foods with our new book, 10 Incredible Foods That Reduce Blood Sugar. Plus, you'll discover the real reason why type 2 diabetes, obesity, and heart disease are increasing at an alarming rate. And find out what really works when it comes to preventing these illnesses by watching our free diabetes-fighting documentary. Plus, get a free recipe book, Amazing Alternatives to Rice, Pasta, and Bread, which contains over 50 delicious and easy to prepare recipes that the whole family will love. These gifts are free and waiting for you to grab them in the description box below. Now back to our video. Now, there aren't many human trials directly comparing sun exposure to vitamin D supplementation due to the innate difficulty of such research. However, Indian researchers managed to do just that. The 2017 trial examined the effects of sunlight exposure versus vitamin D supplementation for people with vitamin D deficiency. The participants were divided into 2 groups and randomly assigned to either get 20 minutes of sunlight exposure per day or take oral vitamin D supplements. Results showed that both groups experienced increased vitamin D levels. However, the effects on cholesterol profiles varied dramatically. The sunlight group had significant decreases in total cholesterol, while the supplement group actually increased their cholesterol levels. This can likely be explained by the fact that vitamin D from sun exposure is water soluble due to the sulfate we discussed earlier, meaning it can be transported throughout the blood without needing to attach itself to cholesterol. Therefore, the liver doesn't need to produce extra cholesterol in order to transport the vitamin D. Thus, the sunlight exposure group improved their cholesterol profile while the supplementation group got worse. Another example of the intricate cycles at play in our bodies. Okay, right about now, you might be saying, hold on, I thought high cholesterol isn't necessarily bad. Yes, as we've discussed in other videos, high cholesterol on its own isn't necessarily as bad as we were told in past decades. As long as blood sugar and oxidation are under control and everything's working well in the body. But when you have high blood sugar, diabetes, or pre-diabetes, and have excess cholesterol floating around, that's when problems occur, with oxidation, artery wall damage, and heart disease. So while some studies have seen improvements in certain markers through vitamin D supplementation, when it comes to bigger picture thinking and improving whole body health, the science suggests that more natural methods of increasing vitamin D, such as regular sun exposure, may be more effective, especially if there are already issues with high blood sugar. Which brings us to our final section, food sources of vitamin D and foods that work synergistically with vitamin D. As we mentioned, some foods are going to naturally provide vitamin D, while others are going to work synergistically to improve blood sugar and vitamin D function. So let's start with natural food sources. These are limited, but are great options to include on your plate. First, we have fish. Fish, particularly fatty fish, are excellent sources of vitamin D3. Salmon is the most popular and generally the most potent when it comes to vitamin D, omega-3, and blood sugar benefits. Consuming a 3.5-ounce serving of cooked salmon provides around 400 to 600 IU, or international units, of vitamin D3. The recommended minimum daily intake is 600 to 800 IU per day for children and adults up to 70 years old. For over 70s, it's a minimum of 800 IU per day, as vitamin D synthesis declines with age. So with that in mind, a salmon meal will provide a good proportion of your vitamin D needs. Other good fish that are going to provide a good dose of vitamin D and at the same time support blood sugar include sardines, mackerel, trout, halibut, herring, and anchovies. These fish obtain vitamin D3 mainly through their diet. They feed on marine organisms such as algae, plankton, and other small fish which contain vitamin D3 or precursor compounds. Pasture-raised eggs are another excellent source of vitamin D and blood sugar balancing compounds. Thanks to the hen's sun exposure, healthier diet, and lower inflammatory compounds, pasture-raised are going to be far more beneficial compared to caged hens. We talk about this in more detail in some of our other videos. Grass-fed beef and beef liver, as well as cheese, can contain small amounts, and for vegans, certain algae can help. Spirulina and chlorella are two great options. They are rich in vitamin D and can help to improve blood sugar control. Finally, some mushrooms, such as shiitake and maitake, can be good sources of vitamin D too. While vitamin D2 is not as effective as vitamin D3, it still does have a positive effect. And to wrap things up, let's talk about vitamin D's best friends, a team of superheroes working together. First, we have vitamin K. Vitamin K and vitamin D demonstrate remarkable synergy, enhancing blood sugar control, insulin function, and calcium function. Vitamin D aids calcium absorption, while vitamin K ensures its correct placement, getting it into the bones where it's needed and preventing arterial calcification, which leads to heart disease. Together, they enhance metabolic health in a number of ways. Some of the best vitamin K-rich foods include leafy greens, avocado, broccoli, blueberries, cabbage, and kiwi fruit. While vitamin K offers many benefits for most people, people taking anticoagulant medications, those with kidney disease, and pregnant or breastfeeding women should talk to their healthcare advisor first, as there can be some side effects. And finally, we have magnesium. Magnesium plays a role in carbohydrate metabolism, insulin sensitivity, and glucose metabolism. Thus, it's vital for reducing blood sugar. Vitamin D, on the other hand, modulates magnesium and maintains its balance in the body. Like many processes in the body, it's an interdependent and self-sustaining cycle. Vitamin D and magnesium work together to keep the whole blood sugar system working optimally. And what foods are good for magnesium? Fortunately, there's some overlap there too. Dark leafy greens, avocado, and fish are great sources, as well as nuts and seeds, legumes, quinoa, bananas, yogurt, and dark chocolate. So there you have it. Vitamin D can make a big difference in blood sugar control, and more broadly, it improves insulin function and other vital processes. But science shows that it depends on other factors. How you get your vitamin D, ideally from foods and sun exposure, without sunburn, of course, rather than supplementation. And if supplementation is necessary, it's important to do so under trusted medical advice and make informed decisions so you're not harming your body by overdoing it and increasing cholesterol. And for best results, make sure you're also getting plenty of natural foods that are rich in vitamin K and magnesium, which are going to be essentially multiplying the benefits in most cases. We hope you found this video useful. Now it's your turn. Share your thoughts, tips, and experiences. Leave a comment below, make sure to subscribe to our channel, and hit that bell button. And don't forget, you can claim your free gifts by clicking the link in the description below or visiting diabeticstalk.com. We want to keep making informative, research-based videos for you, so if you gained value from this video and would like more of it, you can send us a super thanks by clicking the thanks button at the bottom of the video. We're Diabetics Talk, and it's our mission to bring you the best tips and tricks to help you fight diabetes. Thanks for watching. We hope you're having a diabetes-fighting day.